Ecstasy is a language that man has completely forgotten. He has been forced to forget ecstasy by society. Society is against it. Civilization is against it. Society has a huge investment in misery, not in ecstasy. It depends on misery. It feeds on misery. It survives on misery. And it wants you to be in misery as well. The society today is not for human beings. It is using human beings as a means for itself. It is using human beings as a slave for their own benefit. Society today has become more important than humanity, civilization, culture. This has all become more important. Ecstasy is the state nature wants you to be in. You are naturally meant to be in ecstasy without taking any pills. This ecstasy I talk about is an experience of another dimension. Nature wants us to be in this dimension, but society is against it. Every child is born ecstatic. It is something that everybody brings with themselves into this world. It is not something that only happens to great sages or monks. It is a part of being alive. Life is ecstasy. Every child brings this into the world. But then society jumps on the child, starts destroying the possibility of ecstasy, starts making the child miserable, starts conditioning the child. And why is society against ecstasy? Because society cannot control an ecstatic man. Nobody can control an ecstatic man. You cannot enslave him. When you are in ecstasy, nothing is a problem for you anymore. You know how to earn your livelihood. Relationships are not a problem anymore. Money is not a problem anymore. Only when you are miserable, everything becomes a problem. And society wants you to be in misery so that they can enslave you even more, so that they can show you illusions, dreams, and then tell you, we will let you reach there. But first, become a slave to us. Society makes you feel that you will be happy, but tomorrow, today, be a slave. And people in hopes of being happy tomorrow fall into this trap of becoming a slave. Society is neurotic and it cannot allow ecstatic people to be here. Try to understand this mechanism. You cannot control an ecstatic man. It is impossible. You can only control a miserable man. An ecstatic man is bound to be free. Ecstasy is freedom. He cannot be reduced to a slave. You cannot destroy him so easily. You cannot persuade him to live in a prison. He would like to dance under the stars. He would like to walk with the wind. He would like to talk to the sun. He would like to sing with the moon. You cannot control a man like this. He will need the vast, the infinite, the huge, the enormous. He looks at the bigger picture. He is not satisfied with the lies you are giving him. He is not satisfied with the fake hopes you give him. He is not satisfied with the happiness and pleasures you promise him he will get tomorrow, because he knows that he has access to something much more beautiful than this fake happiness and pleasures. Ecstasy is a state much higher than happiness or any pleasure you can think of. Every individual has the birthright to be in ecstasy. You cannot make a slave out of an ecstatic human being. He will have his own life. He will do his own thing. This is very difficult for society. If there are many ecstatic people, then society will feel as if it is falling apart. Its structure will not hold anymore. Listen to this and meditate over it. Ecstasy is against structure. Such a vast universe goes on beautifully without any structure. Animals, birds, trees, everything goes on without any structure. Is man so neurotic that he forcefully needs to be put into a trap? He needs to follow a structure. Man can live without rulers, but he has never been given any opportunity. The rulers don't give you any opportunity. Once you know you can live without rulers, who would like them to be there? Who will support them? From the very childhood, the child is not allowed to taste freedom, because once he understands what freedom is, he will not compromise. He will not compromise for petty pleasures, petty happiness. He will not be ready to live in any dark cell. He would like to die, but he will not allow anybody to reduce him to a slave. He will be assertive, but he will not be interested in becoming powerful over other people. These are neurotic trends, trying to become powerful over other people. That just shows that deep down, you are powerless, and you are just afraid that if you do not become powerful, then other people will overpower you. Once the child knows freedom, then he will never be part of any society. He will remain free, and he will create pulsations of freedom around him. His very being will become a door to freedom. He might know how to exist with society, but he will never become a part of society. This way, his mind is never manipulated by society. He becomes a very successful and creative individual. Money is never a problem for him anymore. Relationships are not a problem for him anymore. Nothing is a problem for him anymore. He goes on to become a beautiful, ecstatic individual. Nature always wanted him to be.